Let us discuss about the internal resistance of a battery. About a battery, we know well that a battery transforms chemical energy to electrical energy. And in a battery, in your early classes, you might have studied that there exist some chemicals due to which some chemical reaction takes place across between anode and cathode, and due to the chemical reactions, continuous flow of electrons takes place. Say if this is a terminal A, which is positive terminal of the battery, this is terminal B, which is negative terminal of the battery, and inside the battery there are chemicals, and due to reaction some mechanism the current flows. Say if battery supplies a current, within the battery the current flows through the chemicals. And obviously we cannot consider these chemicals to be perfect conductors. So when current flows through the internal structure of battery, these chemicals offer a resistance in the flow of current. This resistance we term as internal resistance of battery. And here we can write this internal resistance is actually the resistance offered by the chemical composition of the battery. So whenever current passes through the battery due to its flow within the chemicals, which is actually due to the flow of ions, and we can simply state the mobility of ions in the chemicals will not be as high as that of free electrons in the conductor. So it must offer some resistance which will be higher than the normal conductors or conducting wires. So we can state this internal resistance decreases the flow of current in the external circuit because it is considered in series, because the same current is passing through it. So you must also keep one thing in mind that in electrical circuits, this internal resistance of battery is taken, which is generally considered in series over the battery EMF. Like if the EMF of battery is say 20 volts and it is having say its EMF, the open circuit potential difference across terminals A and B is 20 volt, and say its internal resistance R can be written as 10 ohms. In this situation, we consider this battery to be an equivalent circuit as an ideal battery of EMF 20 volt in series with its internal resistance of 10 ohms. And this combination is considered as a real battery. So here along with this I have explained one more concept, that is the difference between our ideal and a real battery. An ideal battery is the one in which there is no internal resistance which produces only an EMF across the terminals, whereas a real battery is the one in which due to its chemical composition a resistance also exists in series with the EMF. So we can simply state, or we can write that internal resistance of an ideal battery can always be considered as zero. And for a real battery, always in series combination with its EMF, we consider its internal resistance whenever the battery is connected in circuit and we analyze the circuit.